Belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihi Allahu fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to episode number 27 from the series Tawheed First. We are talking about the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how can we single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to his names and attributes. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat, attributing unity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to his names and attributes and his divine essence, comprises two pillars: Ithbat wa Nafi, affirmation and negation. We affirm what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed for himself of names, we believe it. Of attributes, we believe it, we accept it, we do not reject it, we do not deny it. And also whatever the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned of names and attributes of Allah in the authentic hadith. That's the affirmation. Ithbat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Sami'un basir. I am a hearer, I am a seer. I affirm that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I ascended on the throne. Thumma istawa ala al-arsh. I affirm that. I do not reject it. I do not deny it. I affirm also the divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib. Negation. What do you mean by negation? I must also negate whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala negated from himself and the Messenger negated from Allah to be one of his names and one of his attributes. Look at this. Both are here. Look at this. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ. Affirmation. Depend upon the ever-living. Affirmation. I affirm that Allah is al-hay. Look at the negation. الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتِ. You see that? You see that? Affirmation. I believe Allah is the ever-living. I also negate the fact that Allah dies. In the same context. The same context. But when I negate a name or an attribute, when I negate an attribute which was negated for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the authentic hadith, I must affirm the opposite in a perfect manner. So I'm negating Allah doesn't die. I'm negating. أَنَا أَنْفِي الْمَوْتَ عَنِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. But I affirm the opposite of death. أُثْبِتْ عَكْسِ الْمَوْتِ. اللي هو إيه؟ الحياة. But what type of حياة? What type of life? A perfect حياة. That did not precede with no existence, does not, Allah does not need anything to keep him alive, and Allah will not die. You getting it? طيب, let's use another example.
الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم.
Allah, the essence, is the ever-living, the self-subsisting, or the sustainer of his creation. Look at this. I affirm that.
لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم.
So I negate, I dismiss that a slumber of a sleep, nor a sleep in itself can overtake Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat is all about. That you single out Allah's attributing unity to the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two pillars. Hang in there. Two things that you have to do. Affirm. You're probably hearing me all the time what Allah has affirmed and what Allah has negated and what the messenger. Listen. Asma'ullah wa sifatuhu tawqifiyya. The names and the attributes of Allah must come from the revelation. The Quran and the sound hadith. You cannot name Allah with any names that was not mentioned in the Quran or in the Sunnah. You cannot attribute any attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that was not mentioned in the Quran or in the authentic hadith. Period. Qawlan wahida. One statement. Here you go. Negation again, an example of negation. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. And your Lord is not an oppressor to his servants. Now, I am negating the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an oppressor. But at the same time, I affirm the opposite of this, the complete justice. وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Allah does not commit injustice against any. طيب. Let's go to what we affirmed. We mentioned now, I'm going to go with you now. Affirmation of everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed for himself in his book, or which his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed for him without tahrif, distorting the wording or the meaning of the attribute, ta'til, denying them, without takyif, asking how the attribute are, and without tamthil, making any resemblance of them to the creation. This is because Allah knows better about himself than anyone else, and the messenger as well had that knowledge. What I want you to do here is just understand the word affirmation. All that other stuff, just leave it for now. Just hang in there. Tab, let's go to negation. Pay attention to this. To deny for Allah everything which he has denied for himself in his book, or which his messenger denied for him, along with believing that its fully perfect opposite is confirmed for Allah, the Most High. This is because Allah knows better about himself than his creation and his messenger out of all people as well. So denying death for Allah includes affirming the perfect life, denying oppression means affirming the perfect justice. Denying sleep, affirm the perfect being alive and taking care or taking charge of this. Leave this alone, but look at this slide. We stress, brothers and sisters in Islam, on the source. Why do we say we affirm and negate only that which Allah and his messenger affirmed and negated? Why? Because the answer is simple. There is none of Allah's creation look like Allah to use as a model to describe Allah accordingly, nor anyone has seen Allah to describe him. How can you speak about someone you did not see? How can you speak about someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this case, when there is no model, nothing of his creation similar to him? I want to stress, because the people who want to play with the names and the attributes of Allah, once it comes to negating, they say what? Allah doesn't walk in the street. Allah doesn't go to the club. And I'm sorry, I'm saying this just to explain. No, you cannot say that. You only negate what is being negated. You do not come up with other forms of negation. Let me make this clear. Because the people who mess up with the attributes and the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, They come up with extra negations. La, you affirm what is affirmed in the Quran and the Sunnah. You negate what is being negated in the Quran and the Sunnah. You do not add to it. Let's come up to the real business. The methodology to understand Allah's names and the attributes is based on three principles. You must believe it, accept it. One, you cannot make it like in the human. Two, three, you cut off any hope that you can reach the true nature of these names and attributes. Let me read this to you. We believe in Allah, His names and attributes, by affirming and negating. So we believe. You tell me Allah hears, I believe it. Allah sees, I believe it. Allah knows, I believe it. I do not dismiss it. I do not reject it. I do not deny it. I must believe it. This is one. Two, I declare that Allah is above any of His attributes to be resembling any of the attributes of His creation. I cannot say that the attribute of Allah, how in the world? Let's take As-Sami', the all-hearer, the hearer. Allah is the hearer. Tayyib. What do you mean by that? Okay, they're all here. What do you mean by that? Okay. I'm a human being. I hear too, right? So how in the world are you going to make my hearing similar to the hearing of Allah? Or like the hearing of Allah? The first question that I ask you, is the essence of me like the essence of Allah? Allah's essence is divine. Huh? Now, I do hear, I agree, tayyib. Now, I can hear only now and here. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears you and hears the people outside your house. Hears the people outside your office. Hears the people in China. Hears the people in Japan. Hears the people in Seattle, Washington, America. Hears the people in Canada at the same time. He says, if all of mankind from Adam until the last soul born would stand in one place, one valley, and each one of them would make a request. Of course, make dua, ask Allah for something. Of course, what I'm asking for will be different to what you're asking for. Allah will hear all of us at the same time and will give each one of us what we asked. So how in the world are you going to make the hearing of Allah resemble the hearing of the creation? Then sometimes, look at, sometimes in our world, what about al-Jannah? Why Ibn Abbas said about al-Jannah, the only sheer thing, there are bananas in Jannah, but are the bananas in Jannah, are going to be the bananas in this world? They are, only the name is the sheared. But totally different. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. The third principle, dear viewers, and we'll come back and talk a little bit more about this. We cut off any hope that we can understand the true nature of these names and attributes. It is impossible for a human mind to encompass the Lord of the heavens and the earth. I want to say something. نحن نفوض الكيفية ولا نفوض المعنى. We cut off the hope that we can reach the true nature of it. We can comprehend it. We can visualize it. We can figure it out. But we believe that the essence has a nature. The divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a nature. And also the name and the attribute has a nature. We believe that. But we cut off any hope that we can get there. Let's take a short break and come back and figure out how people went astray who neglected, disregarded these three principles as a methodology to understand Allah's names and attributes. Don't go away. I will be right back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
This belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the Holy Scripture. Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the Holy Scripture.
Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. We're talking about the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen, three principles. Make it simple. We believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has an essence, a divine essence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a spirit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a divine essence. We believe that. But no one knows the greatness of that divine essence but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot even comprehend it. You cannot. And don't even try. طيب. The essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has names and attributes. Three principles comprise the methodology to understand these names and attributes. Principle number one, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a divine essence, has names and attributes. We do not reject. We do not deny. There are people who denied some of the names and the attributes, or all of them. We do not deny that. We believe in them. نؤمن بها. Two, we believe that they are not like the humans, not like the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is two. We believe that these, the divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a human essence. It's divine. We believe that the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not like the names and the attributes of the creation of Allah, especially the humans, even if the name is shared. Kareem, Allah is al-Kareem. Sami' Allah is al-Sami' Basir, Allah is al-Basir. So the name is shared, but we cannot say that the name or the attribute is like the name and the attribute of the human. We cannot do that. That's principle number two. Principle number three, we cut off any hope that we can find out the true nature of the divine essence of Allah, also his names and attributes. Brothers and sisters in Islam, look what Sheikh Shanqiti said, and I will translate this to you in English. You must cut off any hope that you can reach the true nature of the names and the attributes and the divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give you that knowledge. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. Allah only giving you certain knowledge regarding that divine essence and the names and the attributes. Add to this, it is a major sin in Islam that you speak about Allah that which you have no knowledge of. وَأَن تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is a major sin, that you attribute things, names, attributes to Allah without knowledge. طيب ولا تقف ما ليس لك به علم. أهو. إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. Now, listen. Dare you try to visualize Allah with your heart, with your mind? You come up with what? With a picture in your head for the divine essence of Allah, or for his attributes? Or you say with your tongue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks like this? Or you draw with your hand, or you make an idol of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say that Allah looks like this? Dare you do this? Oh, dare you do this? طيب يا شيخ, what if the shaitan comes and whispers to me and tells me Allah looks like this? وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. Say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Say, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is none is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُلُّ مَا دَارَ بِبَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ بِخِلَافِ ذَلِكَ. Whatever you reach of a figure for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above this. Add to this, لَمْ يَتَعَبَّدَكَ اللَّهِ بِالْكَيْفِيَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not ask us to figure out how he looks like. No, he did not. لم يتعبدك. And it's not going to affect your iman. It is not going to affect your faith. So why do you do it? Now, let's go to the people who deviated. The people who deviated from that correct methodology. The people who ignored these three principles. The mushrikeen and the mu'attila. The deviation of the mushrik. Al-mushrik, the one who does not believe in the divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also rejected his names. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اسْجُدُوا لِلرَّحْمَانِ. What would I say? قَالُوا وَمَنْ رَحْمَانِ. Who's الرحمن? So they rejected the name of Allah, الرحمن. We have also those who deviated in the area of tashbih. making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liken his creation. Look at that word between the racket, a big word. But listen, what those people did, they affirm the names and the attributes, but here is the wrong thing. They made it look like the human. Allah here is like the human, and the Jews are the top of the line. They say Allah is a human being. He laughs, he cries, and he gets tired, and so forth. لا لا ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Comes in the deviance of the deniers, those who reject the names and the attributes. We have three in the Ummah: Al-Jahmiyyah, Al-Mu'tazilah, Al-Asha'irah. But there are different. They are different once it comes to the level of their deviance. There are other general principles, dear viewers, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, once it comes to the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that all the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are beautiful. They are both titles and descriptions. Asma wa ma'ani. Tayyib. They are tawqifiyya. They are indefinite. Let's go over those quickly in the time we have. All of Allah's names and are beautiful. Wa qimmatul jamal, the top of beauty. Wa sifat qimmatul husn. Qimmatul jamal wa qimmatul husn. The top of the line. The perfection. And once it comes to the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a name, the top of the line, not halfway. The top of the line. What do you mean by they are both titles and descriptions? If I say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-kareem, the generous, that means he is. Some human, by the way, their names is Kareem, like myself. Huh? It's permissible, by the way, to call yourself Kareem, that's fine. But I could be, my name's Kareem, and you come to my house, and you don't even get offered a glass of water. That is what is meant by that. Yani, or somebody, you know, his name is what? Rahim. Rahim. You could actually call yourself Rahim as well. It is permissible. You cannot call yourself Ar-Rahman, but you can call yourself Rahim. And he has no mercy in his heart. Al-Shahid is the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are both titles, a name that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala name himself with, and also a description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to stress, they are all tawqifiyya, meaning the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must come from the divine revelation. That would include the Quran, and also would include the authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with any name, if you describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with any attribute which was not mentioned in the divine revelation, you have crossed your boundaries and you need to stop. The final point here, they are all indefinite. All indefinite. I'm sorry, they are indefinite. Meaning what? They are countless. Because there are a lot of Muslims out there who are under the impression that the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are 99, which is not correct. Dear viewers, I hope I contributed to your understanding of these names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You probably have to maybe watch that more, or listen more, or read more about the subject. But be careful that you try to begin understanding these names and attributes without understanding the rules, because a lot of the people who spoke about the subject, they went astray in that field, and it's very difficult also to explain it. Therefore, dear viewers, I encourage you to force yourself to learn that subject, because it will lead to the betterness of your ibadah, of your worship. It will lead to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it could take you to Jannah, and it will open a lot of doors of joy in this world, which will be inside the heart, due to the fact that you got to know who Allah is and you're going to end up loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't miss the next episode of Tawheed First. We will talk about Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. How can we single out now Allah, the creator, the sustainer, the one who possesses the beautiful name, the attribute, the perfect attribute. How can we single him with our action? How can we worship him alone? Devote him, devote ourselves to him. Till the next episode of Tawheed First. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Faith is belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah. The angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there